So we are going to discuss what are the factors that we should consider while we are finalizing a floor and floor covering for our building or structure. And the various parameters are initial cost, appearance, durability, resistance against dampness, insulation against heat, then fire resistance, noise insulation, that is sound insulation, rigidity, cleanliness and maintenance. Now let's discuss all these parameters one by one in detail. The first one being the initial cost, that is the initial budget. See, the initial cost should be in accordance with the type of building being constructed. Whether it's a museum or storage building or industrial building or a public use building or a private residence. Floor covering of marble is costly, whereas mud covering or mud flooring or murum flooring is used in village where cost is a primary concern. Means depending upon what initial budget you are going to allocate for the floor, you should be selecting that kind of floor, right? Then depending on aspect of appearance needed in that building, the possible future use of that building, that is specifically the floor, the costing should be finalized. Then the next factor is appearance. Floor covering should create a pleasing appearance to the user. Floor covering, when used in the residential structure, should be such that it should reflect light, it should produce calming effect to the user. Appearance of the floor cover matters only in architectural, residential and business building. It has less importance when the floor needs to be strong and sturdy, as in case of storage or industrial building. The next parameter we are going to discuss is its durability. The floor should have a good resistance against abrasion, wear and tear and impact and temperature changes and moisture attack etc. forces. That is, it should withstand all the deteriorating forces for a long period of time. Superior the floor cover, better its durability is. The example is marble, terrazzo and concrete. They have very great durability than brick or mud or murum flooring. Then the next parameter is dampness resistance. Floor should have sufficient dampness resistance so that the atmosphere created inside is healthy. A floor having a problem of absorbing or retaining dampness invites poor atmosphere and unpleasantness inside the building. Concrete, terrazzo stand good against dampness or moisture, while cork, rubber flooring lack in maintaining damp-proof environment inside the building. Then the next point is thermal insulation. Sufficient thermal insulation should be provided by the floor so that comfortable living conditions are created inside the building. The best example for floor being thermally insulated is wooden floor and mud floor. Both these type create perfect thermal insulation even in extreme summers and extreme winters. Then the next parameter is fire resistance. Fire resistance stands important in case of upper floors. When upper floors are fire resistant, they can act as a barrier in case of a fire breakout in that building or structure. The fire resistance of floor should be such that in case of fire breakout or accident, sufficient time should be available for the occupant in that floor so as he can evacuate the structure before the floor heats up to unbearable extent. Concrete, mosaic, terrazzo have good fire resistance, whereas rubber, linoleum and timber floor have very poor fire resistance. In case these types of floor cover are to be used, the floor bases should be made extremely fireproof. The next point is sound insulation. Flooring should be sufficiently soundproof so that when users living on bottom floor should not hear the walking or any other noise from the upper floor when it is being used. Least noise should be created when the floor is subjected to frictional or impact forces during normal activities being carried out in that structure. Wooden, rubber and cork flooring offer a very good noise resistance or sound insulation. In case noise or sound insulation is required, as in case of concrete or marble or any other floor, mats can be laid over it so as to get rid of floor noises to some extent. The next point is rigidity. The floor should be sufficiently rigid so that they can resist any indentation marks on it. It should be able to withstand abrasive forces and impact forces in daily activities like furniture shifting or any other similar household chores. The final point regarding selection of a floor in a structure is its cleanliness. It is important for a floor to be able to get cleaned easily. The floor should be non-absorbent and should resist the entry of oils, moisture or any other material in it. Better the cleanliness properties of floor, more non-slippery it is going to be and it will create a pleasant appearance to the user. So these were some important parameters that you should look while you are going to finalize the type of floor or floor covering for your building. We will cover another important topic in next podcast. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.